promise to satisfy your hunger, your thirst, your sweet tooth. So visit our refreshment center now. Let's go! Show starts
right,
in 7 minutes.
We are live, the Culinary Trends Show on RantRadioNetwork.com. And now we are also on Indy 104, guys.
Yay.
Awesome.
Isn't that exciting?
Yes. Sure. Very. You say so?
I'm excited. Yes, even everybody from the basement, we're excited tonight.
Everyone in
Hello?
The basement.
Yeah.
Hello, are you on?
No.
Yes, she is.
I am. I
yes,
can't
you
hear
are.
Myself.
It's okay.
You can't It's all that stuff you've been drinking the whole time we started.
Maybe. I don't know.
We'll talk about what you're drinking later on. So welcome, everybody. How's everybody doing tonight?
Doing well.
Well, welcome, everybody, if you're watching and listening. I'm Chef Bev Lazo, and to my left, we have...
Wait, which way's
left? Your left. Mm-hmm. My left.
Oh, yeah. Lawrence.
And to
hey,
my
guys.
Right...
Gloria.
And the hot guy right in front of me.
Chef Matt.
Chef
Matt
in the house.
Oh, wait.
Welcome, guys. How was your week?
Okay.
Yeah?
All right.
Yeah. Working hard, playing hard.
Busy.
I know you're busy. You've been busy. We're going to talk to you about it. You got a lot of stuff going on, Chef. Last time we talked to you last week, you know, you were talking about your travels through Portland and Colorado and Vegas.
Idaho. Washington and Vegas, exactly. Colorado.
All in one shot. All in one shot. So, everybody been working? Lawrence, have you been on the road also?
Oh, yeah. Just all over L.A., Orange County.
You know, a lot of people don't realize that we do have real jobs also.
Yeah.
So, Lawrence does work on a truck. What truck do you work on?
Well, currently, I like to call myself the food truck mercenary right now because I tend to bounce around from truck to truck. But currently, most of my shifts have been with the lobster truck.
Okay.
And so I've been mainly with Lobster Truck in LA and OC.
So you're freelancing?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah,
he's the man to go to if you need someone to cover the shift and stuff. Gloria, where do you work?
I'm an accounting assistant.
Oh.
Boring.
Yeah.
Money.
But I do like numbers. So.
Numbers good.
And it gives me money to buy alcohol.
Lawrence fell asleep. Chef, what are you doing right now? You're freelancing pretty much also.
Yes, I do. I have the consulting business in the industry, so I place chefs for pretty much famous chefs you see on TV all over the country. I place for hotels across the world, and we train them, test them, make sure they're not going to wash out on a contract. Then we put them into the industry on a contract. I get a good payday of their percentage of their first year's wage. And that's paid not out of their pocket, but by the hotel or the restaurant themselves.
That's interesting.
And then I have the pasta company.
Oh, I can't wait for your pasta.
And we just signed the contracts this week. I have my new studio kitchen, so we'll be filming in there.
Awesome. Oh. Congratulations.
Yeah,
all right.
Picked up a sponsor, Blue Star Restaurant Equipment, the manufacturers of the ranges.
Oh, nice.
So they do high-end ranges and stuff. They're outfitting my whole studio.
Awesome. So when should we be expecting an invite for the tour?
When can the Culinary Trend Show come on?
We're gonna do that here. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a couple media things, trying to get them done before the end of the month. But... and then I'll have to bring everyone back because right now it's Sub-Zero Wolf, Melee, and Decor.
Wow.
Is
That's
all the equipment
big
in
time.
There right now. So we're going to take all of that out, basically, and then we're going to bring in all of Blue Star's equipment in. They're going to set it up the way I want it. Melee's going to stay. I'm putting in French top stoves.
Wow.
So I'm going really high end. Nice. I've got an actual in-counter deep fryer.
Oh, we're coming over to play in your kitchen.
Yeah.
Just show me pictures if you don't want anything broken.
Okay.
Yeah, she just spilled popcorn oil
on
her.
I'm
trying to ask her to pop popcorn for us because today is movie night for us. And I asked Gloria one thing.
Yeah, I know.
Simple. Just can you make some popcorn?
Fail.
Yeah, so I'm Chef Bev. I work for Border Grill. And I also do my own private stuff when I need to. So, but a lot of things are happening in the future for all of us. I know that. And big things coming for me, but I can't say anything right now. But we'll wait till fall. Well, it's almost fall, huh?
Yeah. That's,
oh, my
that's
God.
That's like next week.
Now, you'd have to wait another few weeks.
Okay.
<then.
laughs> Well, you could just walk outside and you wouldn't guess it.
No,
would
it's hot today. We're here.
It was warm. Hottest day all week this week.
Southern California.
Yeah.
I'm hot right now. They should turn the air conditioning on, but I'm always hot every week.
It's them hot flashes.
Shut up, Lawrence. Next week, Lawrence won't be on the show.
All right, so today's my last day here with Culinary Trends.
You can find him on the lobster truck. But we are celebrating the movies because there's always lots of great snacks that, you know, it's grown ever since when I was a kid. It was just popcorn and maybe like hot dogs and nachos and some candy. But now going to a movie, like, there's so many choices. They have, what, chicken fingers now and
pizza.
Hamburgers. So we brought our own food to interpret, well, what would we want to eat if we were going to run our own? Because I'd love to have my own movie theater and movie
restaurant. Oh,
that'd
be awesome.
Wouldn't that be cool? You could be my bartender.
Yay. See? I just have to go to school.
No, you don't need to go to school.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Laura, you know all the drinks already.
No, you don't.
So basically, we are celebrating the movies tonight. And there's other holidays. There's always a special holiday for food. So what special holiday is it today?
Well, let's see. Today is Thursday the 29th. And it is, according to this list here, more herbs, less salt day, I guess, to promote more healthy eating.
Mrs. Dash.
Yes.
Mrs. Dash. Happy birthday.
So more herbs, less salt, more MSG. Is that what that is? Okay.
Probably.
And National Chop Suey Day.
Oh,
which
nice.
For a lot of folks that don't know, that assume that chop suey was a Chinese dish, it's actually, it was invented here in America. Mm-hmm. I think up in San Francisco in Chinatown.
Yes,
give us a history about that.
I don't know the. I do know that it was started in San Francisco, mm-hmm. and it was just something that they made. Someone had come in and wanted something special, not normal, and so they slapped it together. Mm-hmm. Your fortune cookie comes from San Francisco.
Yeah,
right.
Fortune
it's
cookie
not
as
a
well.
Chinese thing.
Yeah,
either.
Yeah, yeah.
So basically, they had leftovers, and they're like, "Oh, we'll just give them whatever they want."
No, it's typical San Francisco hippies.
I'm talking about chop suey.
I want something healthy, man. And you know, they gave them chop suey. So
there's like a lot of holidays today. What
Let's
else?
See, National Lemon Juice Day.
Ooh,
so you know,
juice.
If you have an open wound, just squeeze it on there.
Mix it with your herbs. No herbs or more herbs, unless
or in a drink.
In a drink, let's see.
There you go. There you go. Drink. Nice lemon drop.
And, you know, we got Kamikazes Labor Day weekend coming up. So, you know, not only there is Labor Day, we have three more things to celebrate.
For the long weekend. Let's see. Tomorrow is National Toasted Marshmallow Day.
Yum.
So get them s'mores ready.
Yes. It's too hot.
It's cold somewhere.
Yeah.
The 31st is Eat Outside Day. And in this weather, hell no. Hell no.
Well, a lot of people go to picnics on Labor Day or have barbecues. Like, who's having a barbecue this weekend?
No.
I'm working, no. So.
I'm working too. Chef?
No.
I'm dog sitting.
You're dog sitting.
So barbecue with her? Okay.
No, I usually smoke a lot at the house. I
Wait,
have a smoker going.
Okay.
And
right. Yeah. I'm just making sure.
Well, with the hair and everything, I could, and the beard. Yeah, hey. Yeah.
That's Chef Matt's weekend.
But you know what? It's been so hot lately that it's no fun to barbecue when it's hot outside.
Yeah.
You're just like, oh.
Well,
I think maybe with age. I know younger it didn't bother me as much.
I think all of us, yeah.
Yeah.
All of us. Because we were able, I was remembering first day of school was always hot.
Yes.
Always hot. But our parents always put us in our, back in my day, corduroys and a sweater. And it's 110 degree weather off.
I went to private school, so that was like my uniform was just always like a button down shirt, dress pants, and it was just like middle of August, late August, and it's just like it's the hottest days of the year.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, they never let us have shorts in private school. We did. We're allowed to have short sleeve shirts though, dress shirts. Mm-hmm. But
yeah, I went to private school and we didn't have uniforms.
Yeah, so we had either you could wear.
What'd you wear?
Blue bottoms, white
clothes.
Top.
Yeah, back in the day for me, it was corduroys and
couldn't have a label on. So if your pants had a label, you had to take that brand off. So it was kind of interesting. Well, I guess it was good for the kids that had to wear tough skins.
I guess. Yeah, that's us. That's our age group. Well, you know what? Since we're celebrating movies, I want to give out a prize today.
Okay.
I want to give out a pair of movie tickets. So I know I love going to the movies. Well, thank you. Thank you. So we are going to play a contest. We're going to play a trivia game. 855-693-4897. You have to guess the movie. If you can guess the movie, I will send you a pair of movie tickets. You could go on a date with somebody, or you could save one for yourself for next time.
You could go watch a movie twice by yourself.
Yes. Hey, that's a good
one. Which I've done.
Forever Alone.
Don't sneak into another movie after
Which I've done.
Oh, we used to do that all the time when we were kids.
People still do that.
I did three movies, four movies in one day.
We'd go to the Family Four Cinema, and they all had double features back then, so it's eight movies, and we go the first thing in the morning and move from theater to theater to theater, yeah, and leave when it closed. You were there opening to close.
That's nice.
And they must have known we were there the whole time, but there's no way they could have missed us, but they never said anything.
You know, that's what I'm thinking. I was like, once I used to go on Saturday, you know, my whole family used to switch from movie theater to movie theater, and they must have known we were there.
Were you in the stroller still and they just left you and ran out?
No, I did this when I was in high school.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, let's read off that movie. Did I give it to you?
No, I don't have it.
No?
She lost her script.
You lost your script. You're fired already. Okay, here's the scene.
You know what? I think it's outside.
Is it outside? Scene is...
Nicely done.
A couple go... They go out on a date, but actually they're not going on a date. So he takes her out to dinner, okay? At this diner.
And they order a hamburger.
Yes. And they order a hamburger, and he orders a steak, right? Mm-hmm.
The waiter is?
And
both bloody.
Both order it bloody as hell. Mm-hmm. And then to wash it all down, they have to drink a very expensive shake. Mm-hmm. So to work off all that food, they ended up doing a...
Dance contest.
So if you know that movie, give us a call, 855-693-4897. I think we have a call on line one, Gloria.
Oh.
Let's see who it is.
Who wants to talk to
me? It might be like New Mexico again.
Hello.
Hi. Hello?
Hello.
Hi. Who's this?
Hi. This is Jeannie.
Hi, Jeannie. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Fine. How can we help you tonight?
I just saw the photo on Instagram to call in live, so I just wanted to say hi to my cousin Lauren.
Oh my God!
Shout out to cousin Lauren.
Hi, cousin Lauren.
What's up, cousin? How you doing?
All right.
This is East Coast over here.
Ain't it past your bedtime?
Isn't it like 1 o'clock in the morning? Or it's 12.
It is 11:15.
It's still early. It's still early. It's early. Thank you for listening. We appreciate it. Even though you want to do a shout out, that's all good for me, girlfriend.
That's all it is.
No food question or anything?
No, I love food. Well, you know, I'm half Filipino, so I do eat all day long.
See, she's perfect for the show. You need to call back next week because we're going to eat with our hands with rice. We eat with our hands, right? Well, we should eat with
our
hands.
That's right. I eat with my hands.
Do you have your legs up on the seat when you eat?
Yes.
There, she's half Filipino. Well, thank you for calling.
I'm a total fama.
Oh,
yes, she is.
She is. See?
I'll tell you what, Jeannie. Anytime you manage to come back to LA, come down. We'd love to have you here on the show with us.
Please come
here in the studio.
I know. I do shows on the East Coast. I do the comedy shows on the East Coast. So I'll come to the West Coast.
Do me a favor. I'm going to put you on hold. We're going to get your information. We'd love to talk to you like in the next few weeks. Thank you for calling. All right.
No problem.
All right. How do we put him on hold? We're not
getting this little boy. This little girl. Their mother and father, too. They all have an urge, and oh, what an urge, for something to munch and chew.
Choo choo.
Now these are just swell, and this rings the bell. The popcorn is crispy and hot. Then others again have a terrible yen for a drink and hits the spot.
Go, go.
So if you want candy, the lobby is handy. A counter with sweets and a crew. With your kind permission, we'll have intermission. We're ready to serve all of you.
Huge deal. For some, it's the largest project they'll take on in a lifetime. Choosing your team may be the most important part of ensuring a successful building project. Starting a project by working closely with Core Design will create what's just right for your life.
Experts know that for pastry, Baker's Bodega has it all. Exclusive brands like Wesco Bankmark, Satin Ice, and Pastry Pride. One-on-one day seminars for cake decorating and gelatin art. So for our service, wide range of ingredients and supplies, and for the low prices, Baker's Bodega has it all. But you don't need to be an expert. Baker's Bodega, 7869 Paramount Boulevard in Pico Rivera. Come, we're waiting for you.
attention. When it comes to tequila, two things matter. Heart and passion. Never compromising integrity for mass production. Number One Tequila delivers the goods. Taste the heart and passion of Mexico in every bottle. We make it right. We make it fun. Superior Tequila. There's only Number One. There's only Number One. There's only Number One.
A home is the biggest investment in most people's lives. Buying or selling should be a positive experience.
Whether you want to be a wealthy real estate investor or just trying to find a place to call home, at AJR & Associates, we focus on the client's needs.
We understand the market better than most. Let us bring the value to you and make the right choice.
AJR & Associates, making your dream house a reality. Call us today for a free consultation at 562-882-1976. Or you can log on to www.hgrrealtors.com.
With a track record of great results, bringing knowledge, wisdom, and expertise to you. Hablamos Español.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat.
The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
All right, we are back. The Culinary Trend Show.
I almost killed the show during the break.
Yeah, you like...
My bad.
We thought it was like a brownout or something.
A little technical
Lawrence almost ended our show tonight.
I leaned on the wrong button, I guess.
See, this is your last day then. Yeah. This is your last day. Well, welcome back. If we have to do the... you should have got that little scene thingy that we had for the trivia. It was outside.
No, I'm pretty sure you confused the listeners and viewers enough with your description to make it difficult.
Well, if you're just coming in, you know, if you know the answer, give us a call, 855-693-4897. Or if you want to do a shout out
to Cousin Lauren.
What about us? We chop liver.
Yeah. Yeah, where's our family? They're not going to call in?
Yeah,
my cousins
right.
aren't listening.
Well, at least you have a fan out there. We'll keep you there.
I have one. Okay. I managed to draw one listener in. So, yeah.
So, we are talking about movies. I love those commercials.
I love them.
I wish they would still bring them back. I mean, instead of the long, long, long commercial. Have you been to the movies lately? It takes 45 minutes to actually see a movie.
Well, I love the trailers.
There's a minimum of at least 5 trailers before the movie starts, especially for a new release. Then there's 10 minutes of just straight commercials.
Yeah, like, I don't know when the whole commercial thing came up. Let's tie it's been like Verizon with shutting off your phone or something.
Yeah, it's been like...
Oh, Sprint, is your phone like, dreaming?
Yeah.
Within the last 10 years, they figured they have a captive audience.
You know, if they were really smart, what they should have done is they should have just put cell phone jammers in every theater. They do them in colleges and stuff. Oh. Why can't they do it in a theater? Then you don't have to deal with all
now,
these idiots.
See, now they're listening.
If you have someplace like the... Alamo Drafthouse, they actually have a strict no phone use policy where if you go ahead and complain to an usher, they'll send someone in and no tolerance, there's a zero tolerance policy, and they'll actually kick people out.
Oh, wow.
And they actually have a promo that they run before their shows where someone that was kicked out left an angry voicemail about being kicked out for using her phone, and so they play that as their...
Nice.
There's zero tolerance texting policy.
What's the name of this?
The Alamo Draft House.
I think we need to try and find that.
Out in Austin, Texas. Yeah, it's on YouTube. You can find the clip on YouTube.
I've been to restaurants where you can't have them. They will, if it goes off, they will throw you out of the restaurant.
Yeah. So
you can't take a photo of your beautiful dish.
No.
We can't. Not allowed.
I've actually been to a sushi restaurant here in LA where... They have a no cell phone policy, and if your cell phone goes off or comes out somehow, your bill magically appears at your table and you're done. So
my sister, when she heard that a few restaurants weren't allowing their cell phone, you know, your cell phone to take pictures, she goes, "See, Gloria, no more food porn for you."
Well, I don't. picture-wise, I don't think, as long as you don't use the flash and you're not disturbing others, there shouldn't be a big deal.
Yeah,
with
but that's
that.
The problem is a lot of people don't know how to turn off the flash function on their phones. And so if you're there sitting in a darkened room, darkened restaurant, and you see that flash go off, it's just like, oh, come on.
Kind of ruins a moment. Not everyone gets to go and eat at nice places. So you've just
you
ruined something.
Yeah, yeah. Too.
At the movie theater?
No.
Maybe
restaurant.
Months to go to or something?
Yeah, yeah.
I put it on my food and then I take pictures.
Oh, I remember that when we went to. I remember that one. Okay. Well, you know what? Let's talk about, you know, it takes so long to get the movie started. By the time the movie starts, I'm sure your snacks are done.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so I think I want to introduce what we were we're going to enjoy eating, something that we would like to have at a movie theater, because I'm not a big fan of their pretzels or hot dogs.
I do like their pizza.
Their pizza's pretty good?
Yeah.
Frozen. And they have
DiGiorno from AMC does DiGiorno.
They have mozzarella sticks, jalapeno poppers now. And, you know, it's like a bag of Tostitos, and they give you processed cheese too, and that's like $10, you know. So Lawrence and I brought something, but I want to introduce what I brought. I made some sliders. This is like when I start my pop-up, which hopefully will be soon. This is going to be on the menu. It's my BD sliders. I named it after a good friend of mine because she decided to name it herself because we had no name. Korean slider with a Asian slaw that has a rice vinegar, some sambal, and then I did a sriracha aioli and some caramelized onions. So tell me what you guys think about that. I think I have some napkins. So again, this is like stuff that I would want to eat at, you know, if I'm going to pay all that money at a movie theater, I want to have something good to eat, you know. So that would be my idea. What do you guys think? If it was warm, it'd be better, but...
I'd buy it.
Would you buy it?
Yeah, I'd buy it.
So, I mean, they should, yeah. And then I did a, do they serve chips?
They do.
Do they?
I think some do.
So I did my version of kettle chips and cheese. So it's a feta parmesan cheese sauce with black pepper, freshly cracked black pepper, and some green onions to give it that.
I've been eating these all show, so
yeah. You
already know how I feel about this one.
Yeah.
But the slider is really good.
So
as well.
The combo together, I mean, would you pay? How much would you pay?
I love this cheese sauce.
How much would you pay for a combo like that? Would you want one or two sliders?
Oh, definitely two.
Two sliders, and
yeah,
then
you need at least
you
two
need
sliders.
Two sliders.
And then how much would you think a movie theater would charge for this?
Probably $10, $9.99. I'm guessing.
Oh no, a movie theater.
A little more.
Today's prices, this combo by itself would easily be $15 to $20.
Well, let's talk about, there's a lot of movie theaters out there that serve really good fresh food now. Some they call it, what, dine-in theaters now,
mm-hmm.
Matt?
CineFamily, I think, is one.
The Arclight.
Arclight's doing
it. Mm-hmm. UltraStar in Anaheim Garden Walk.
UltraStar is starting to, yeah, they do liquor and everything.
They do
also.
Liquor. Plus they
the Alamo Draft House.
They do paninis
well.
And fresh hummus.
Do now? Do they serve? I've never been to one. I'd like to go
I've
to
never
one.
Been
I know
to
there's one in
I
Pasadena
to.
Also.
Yeah.
Do they serve it to you? Or
yeah,
you
it's an upcharge and for your ticket. And what they do is they just deliver everything to your seat to you.
Nice.
So it's really cool.
And they also have alcohol.
Yes.
Yeah,
they serve wine and beer.
Wine and beer.
You brought some stuff for us today.
I did.
In theme of a movie.
Yeah, next segment. I'll make it.
Will you make it next segment?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you get your booze, you get your food for, what, $20 or more? Wait, how much are tickets
now? No, the
now?
Upcharge is actually for the, at UltraStar, I think the upcharge is only $6.
Oh, that's
you,
not bad.
You
that's
pay
not bad
for everything on top of
right.
that, and there's a premium on the price of everything. But it's only $6 to pay for that service and to have those chairs and that ability.
Yeah.
So
I remember reading, I think it was a year ago when they barely opened, that the ticket was $16 to get in, and then you pay for what you got or something. Hmm. I'm not sure.
But
well,
but you can still go.
You can go
on a matinee and get mm-hmm. the matinee deal on that, and it's only the upcharge
that's
now.
Not bad.
So they changed it a little bit. I know originally, I think it was something else. The company that built that theater over at Garden Walk had gone belly up. And then Ultra Stars, I think, out of San Diego County, they came in and bought it out.
They bought it out.
And they've been doing a good thing. I mean, I go, students get matinee all the time. Mm-hmm. So I still have a student ID.
Oh, nice.
It has no expiration on it, so it's great.
I should find mine.
Yeah, I need to go register for classes and then immediately drop everyone.
The other thing a lot of people don't realize is, you know, if you were ever a SAG or AFTRA person and you have a valid card, you can go to any movie anywhere in the country, and it's free.
Nice.
You don't have to pay. You just show your ID and
walk
in. What
about food? Does it cover food?
Any movies?
No, no food.
Any productions out there can give me some points to put towards a card. That'd be great.
Well, we're talking about previews because it takes, 20 minutes to get into the movie. I found a new movie that's coming out really soon. I can't wait to see it. So I think it's coming out late fall. Alan, pull it up. Let's see what we're going to see this fall. It's a hot new movie. I saw the trailer and I was really excited because
the Infinity Orb has been swiped.
Call the police!
No. I know someone who specializes in covert artifact recovery.
Oh, a thief.
She prefers the term explorer. Dora.
Hola, mis amigos.
Cameras captured a man in purple mask and gloves removing the orb.
Swiper, you old fox.
You know where to find him?
No, but I know someone who does.
Last I heard, he was in Guadalajara.
Gracias. There's someone I need to see. Hola, Diego.
Dora, it's been a while. I haven't seen you since
I was this many.
Soy backpack. What do you need? Miracle
being a star. We still have that contest. I want to give out movie tickets again.
The couple was going on a date,
which actually they weren't supposed to go on a date, right?
Something like that.
They weren't on a date.
And they go to a diner.
Yes.
Yes. And their waiter is
Buddy Holly.
Buddy Holly.
They order a hamburger and a steak.
Yeah. Well, the diner was in L.A. and it's very famous, too.
Yes.
They order a burger and a steak and both bloody.
Bloody as hell. Bloody as hell. And then they drink a very expensive shake. Mm-hmm. And they do a dance-off. So if you know that movie, I want to give you a pair of tickets. It's 1-855-693-4897. Once again, that's 1-855-693-4897. You are listening to Rant Radio, and we are also on 104, Indy 104. I'm so excited. So everybody back east or around the nation, thank you for listening. I hope you're enjoying the show. And once we get back, we are going to do some popcorn tasting and some booze. Because that's how we roll. Yo. We'll be right back. Nurses Life Express provides unique apparel for all the hardworking nurses that wear many hats. It's apparel that expresses nurses' amazing, humorous, and caring personalities. After all, nurses are as influential as their united goal to help others. Nursing's not easy, but somebody's got to do it. For more information, please call 562-270-4312 or visit their website at www.nurselife.com. www.nurselyfe.com. NursesLife.com, where nurses' lives are expressed.
Three balls, two strikes, the pitch. Make your team look like pros with custom lineup cards. Whether you're a travel team, rec team, all-star team, or just some old guys playing slow pitch, we can make your team look a little better with some custom lineup cards. For the umpire, for the opponent, for the scorekeeper, for the dugout, no matter where your lineup card goes, you will look like a big league team with your team logo and name on top of your personalized lineup card. Just visit CustomLineupCards.com. With the best prices in town, you are sure to hit a home run with us. Visit CustomLineupCards.com and go pro.
you watching the game at home? Why? Come watch it at Mambo Grill, the hottest spot in Downey. You'll have good food, drinks, and a great time at a low price. We have the coldest beer in our sports bar, where you can enjoy the game on any of our huge flat-screen TVs. And when your home team wins, you get 25% off anything in Mambo Grill. We're on Downey Avenue, one block north of Firestone, or visit us on the web. Mambo Grill, love at first bite.
Hey, bro, this is a good game. You know what would make it better?
What, bro?
A michelada.
A michelada? What's a michelada?
A michelada is somewhere in the middle of a Mexican Bloody Mary and a Mexican margarita.
Oh, I got you covered, bro.
You got a cup in your pocket?
No, sir. I got my pocket-sized michelada. Mucho macho michelada.
Pocket-sized?
Pocket-sized, so you can take it with you anywhere you go.
Where'd you get that at?
At the nearest convenience store, and you can also buy it at muchomachomichelada.com.
You know what would make it better? After we get drunk, if they had a line, we could call.
We can call their drunk line. You can leave a message and then log on to the site and listen to your stupidity afterwards.
What's that number?
It's 855-MICHE69.
What's that number again?
855-MICHE69.
Awesome. Mucho macho michelada.
It's refreshment time, folks.
Taste that beats the others go. Pepsi pours it on. Taste that beats the others go. Pepsi pours it on.
Yum, yum. It's a meal in itself. Our all-meat super dog. Enjoy one now.
Show starts in...
More at the drive-ins. You saw those more at the drive-in.
Yeah, because they was more of an encouragement to get out of the car to get your concession.
Yeah, I'm on.
And stuff like that. And, the thing that I love, did any of you guys see the Grindhouse double feature that Robert Rodriguez and Quentin Tarantino did? Where they kind of brought back those interstitials in between each one? That was awesome.
The intermission.
But the thing is, there's not too many drive-ins left. There's one here.
The Vineland drive-in?
Vineland
drive-in. Yeah. That's the only one left in L.A.
Really?
That's still running as a drive-in.
There's one in two. Upland.
In I Upland? Think. That's all the way in Upland.
Yeah, I know, but I used to live in Ontario.
Yeah, it's so right it there. I've been to that one.
Is that one still
it's
running
still
as well?
Running.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Nice.
Weren't they were doing them at the Orange County Fair for a while, too? They were doing a deal over at the fairgrounds.
I don't know.
No?
Yeah, my friends went a couple times, invited me, but I never went.
Yeah,
oh,
I mean, I still like going to the drive-in. The one in Vineland, every single show is a double feature, so that's always fun.
Well, I think we need to try some popcorn because I'm hungry.
All right.
So you brought us some popcorn.
Yes.
What did you bring
did
us today,
well,
Chef?
Well, this is kind of inspired. Like my favorite theater here in LA is the ArcLight. They're groups of theaters, and they do a caramel corn there that I love. Every time I go, I have to get their caramel corn. But this is also kind of like my interpretation of this and the Cracker Jack, because initially the show was supposed to be about baseball, but somebody changed at the last minute. So what I made is I made my own version of kind of like the Cracker Jack with caramel corn. What
now,
I made,
do they give you a big steel bowl?
No,
oh, okay.
That's my bowl from home. But so what I made was I made a bourbon caramel sauce. I used the Breaking and Entering bourbon from St. George's Spirits up in Alameda to make the bourbon. I actually cooked I popped the popcorn in
so good
rendered bacon fat, and then I tossed those bacon bits into there as well. And then I also added peanuts, but then I also added cashews because I really like cashews as well.
That's so good.
Ooh. I like
how much would you pay for that in a movie?
That right there, I mean, like concession stand prices, that's like maybe $5-6.
For how many ounces?
Probably a good 10
that's
ounces.
A little tiny bag.
Yeah.
And if you wanted that barrel, probably like $15.
Yeah.
With a free refill.
The big old bucket.
Yeah.
Well, I have a listener who just texted me, and They're loving the show. Thank you for listening, Angelique and Mark. And Mark hates how long it takes to for all the movie previews. I think we all hate it.
You know, I love previews.
The previews, I love. It's the commercials that kill me. That I mean, that is what I love watching.
I don't
previews.
Need to know what show is going to be on TV.
Yeah, why are they
I
showing those now?
TV.
They're showing a lot of like CBS stuff, right?
TNT. Stuff like that.
Lawyers. If you hurt yourself.
The new drama.
You know what it's caused, though? It's caused a problem with it running so long before the movie that you end up almost always having to go to the restroom in the middle of the movie.
Right.
And that is my biggest, biggest pet peeve, because how am I going to see that part that I missed?
Well, there's an app now that, like, actually can tell you, like, if you're going to watch a movie, when's the best time to take a bathroom break.
So, really?
Yeah, yeah. I forget what the name is.
That's weird.
Off the top of my head, but yeah. Like, you look up all the new movies that are coming out, and it tells you, like, the best time to take a bathroom
when
break.
There's a lull in the story or it's going to be a waste of time or something.
That app is, like, super valuable.
Do you use it?
No, I don't, because I forgot
the
name.
Where do you put it? Do you put it here against your bladder or what?
No, you look it up. You look it up before the movie starts, and you're just like, all right, when that part happens, then I can go use the bathroom.
You have to pee. Yeah. Oh, Siri says, talk about Siri. I found another preview. Hopefully we get the sound of this. Because this is for you, Mark, that you're listening. You hate previews. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to throw this movie preview out. It's coming out hopefully in by Halloween.
Oh,
because it's a scary movie.
Oh, nice.
I love scary movies.
So do I.
All right. Let's
see. All right. Let's do it. When we're done with him, he'll be more of an outcast than a seagull at an Adam Sandler movie.
This holiday season...
Oh man, this is so great. I can't wait to open presents.
You guys won't believe what I got you.
Be careful what you wish for.
The new iPhone?
Whoa, thanks, Michael.
iPhone's for everyone.
Hey, Siri, what's the meaning of life?
Life has no meaning.
Don't be such a downer, Siri.
It's true. You're alive and then you die. You die. You die. Die.
Die. Your
damn thing's broken.
Hey, Siri, do I turn right or left here?
Continue driving straight.
Straight?
Listen, I think there's something wrong with those phones. Are you there?
Don't come over. Just get out of the house. Get out of the house!
Which makes a total of 3 bodies found this week alone.
The water damage voids your warranty.
It's not water. It's blood.
The present you think you're tearing into is actually tearing into you.
Hey, does anybody have a knife?
There's an app for that.
I'm telling you, there's nothing wrong with the iPhones.
We must kill the humans. Yes, kill the humans.
Ah, please stop! Somebody help!
Let me go!
Sorry, I don't understand.
I think it's dead.
You killed it?
No. I forgot to plug it in last night.
I am so grateful I'm an Android.
I'm Android.
I'm also scared of their phones.
To who has Siri? Oh, Lawrence.
It's like
Lawrence, keep driving straight.
Pay no attention to the iOS corner right here that I've got going.
Oh, we love movie previews. I can't wait to see that. That looks exciting.
That does.
It does. So I think we need a drink for that. For that type of movie?
Ooh, a drink.
So tell us what you're going to be making us today. Gloria's making something fresh. It's not going to be like click, click,
click, click.
Pour.
I do like beer, as many of our listeners know. But since it's movie themed, I went online and I found a lot of 2 recipe books. One was an unofficial Harry Potter recipe book. And the other one's an unofficial Hunger Games book.
Interesting.
So I got a recipe off the Harry Potter one, and it's butterbeer.
Nice.
Which they drink a lot of butterbeer there. But this is an adult classic.
So they weren't drinking this at Hogwarts?
I don't think so. I think it's the light version.
It was the bar at Hogwarts.
Yeah, it was. Right? Where all the professors went to.
Yeah, the professors' lounge.
And they have that code that they would tell the paintings, you know, bar please.
So we have root beer.
Okay. Root beers first.
You need vanilla schnapps, but I didn't have any. So I got the whipped cream liqueur.
That was... where can we find these little things?
I get these at BevMo. Okay. No, BevMo or Total Wine. And then we have the butterscotch liqueur.
Oh, I love that stuff.
Liquor stores are pretty good at having
liquor stores, yeah. They are.
My corner one. Pops, yeah. You think they'll have, like, oh, can I have the whipped cream schnapps?
You know, where you walk in and they hawk.
And they'll be like, what are you talking about?
Yeah. You buy now.
You pay. You pay first. Then I show you schnapps.
Okay, so I'm going to put the whole little
nice.
Bottle.
Look at that. Look at that, Matt.
She's, you know,
do
us,
it.
Huh?
She's do it to taste, you know.
Do it to taste. To dang.
To taste, so just pour the whole.
That's her taste right there.
I've been drinking a long time.
Oh, get to know. Get to know. That's
time.
Your bio for yes. the show.
Stay tuned next week when we stage an intervention.
It'll be like How I Met Your Mother. I come in and there'll be a huge banner intervention. All right. It's yeah.
Wow.
So then I do.
Holy cow. Smell that. That's nice.
Hey, it's
like
really
that.
Good.
I would hate to see what happened if you actually brought the full-size bottle.
If I pass out, you know, this is something I would like for you to put, you know.
That's what I said. Do
smelling
it to
salt.
Wait, I just went in my nose. Smelling salts.
I'll read the recipe.
Okay, read the recipe.
And then you will see.
Do we need
the
to
difference.
Stir, or do we have to do a magic because
isn't
it's
it
a Harry Potter?
Isn't root beer supposed to have, or beer supposed to have head on top?
I know, but.
Jeez.
So do we do a magic thing like Harry Potter? Like, you know.
You know what? This is amazing.
This smells like something.
Stupefy! No?
Stupefy?
Right after this, stupefy!
This smells like something a pedophile would serve.
Oh. And Lawrence, hello?
How would you know, Lawrence?
Try it.
It's so good. I love this drink, Gloria. I'm going to give
thank
you applause
you.
For that.
Okay.
It's just
so
me.
So the recipe calls for, this is only for one person, one part butterscotch schnapps. I can't talk anymore. One
she's
part
had
vanilla
a little too much schnapps.
And root beer.
That's it?
Yeah.
That's it.
One part, one root
and
beer.
And that is that for one person only?
For one person.
Yeah, so it's a single drink. It's what
it's
are
a
these
single
it's
drink.
Really, really good. I recommend that for everybody.
One half an ounce.
Lawrence, you have to share. Stop
what?
Stop putting it in your flask. That's so good.
It is. It's really
good. Yeah, these
good.
Aren't that strong anyways.
They're
not. Liqueurs,
did you
so
try
they're
the
only
chef?
30, 40% alcohol.
We have fun here at the show, if you notice. We like to...
There's another one I tried. I made it earlier.
Recipe for that.
Which it was called the French 75, which was inspired by Casablanca.
Oh, that's
oh
nice.
Okay.
It was...
that's the one I have here.
That's the one that you have. It is 1/2 ounce cognac, but I use brandy, which I didn't have cognac. 1/2 ounce simple syrup. 1/2 ounce of fresh lemon juice, and then sparkling wine. Your favorite sparkling wine would work.
So you use lemon juice, isn't it? Lemon juice day or something?
Lemon
is that
juice,
what you said earlier?
Yeah.
Wow. So
I'm
tied
I'm ready
it in.
For that. I'm in heaven with that butter. What is it called? Butter beer.
It's
so dangerous.
Good. And this is it the is. Dark. If you want butter beer light instead of root beer, use cream soda.
No, I like this because the flavors really meld yeah. well. I think we have that video you were talking about, the no texting policy.
Oh, yeah, from the Alamo Draft House.
I want to hear this.
Yeah, let's do that before we go to break.
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, I was wondering if you guys actually enjoy treating your customers like a piece of shit. Because that's how I felt when I went to the Alamo Draft House. Okay? You know what? I didn't know that I wasn't supposed to text in your little crappy-ass theater. It was too fucking dark in that place for me to find my seat, all right? I was using my phone as a flashlight to get to my fucking seat. So excuse me for using my phone in USA, United States of America, where you are free to text in a theater. I was not aware that I couldn't text in your theater, all right? I've texted in all the other theaters in Austin, and no one ever gave a fuck about what me I was doing on my fucking phone, all right? And it was on silent. It wasn't on loud. It wasn't bothering anybody. You guys, obviously, were being assholes to me, and I'm sure that's what you do, you know, to rip people off. You take my money, and then you throw me out, you know? I will never be... coming back to your Alamo Draft House or whatever, I'd rather go to a regular theater where people are actually polite. And, you know, I'm going to tell everyone about how shitty you are. And I'm pretty sure you guys are being assholes on purpose. So thanks for making me feel like a customer. Thanks for taking my money, asshole.
I think she was drunk.
She sounded like she was.
But I would say
she's right back. More culinary 20 something. Show with Chef Bev, yeah. Gloria, and Lawrence. We'll only be here on RentRadioNetwork.com.
TicketSurgeon.com reaches at 855-WIN-4199.
Did you get caught speeding, texting while driving, or doing anything else you weren't supposed to do?
Give us a call. Don't miss work. Don't lose out on the money. Don't get any more points. What about your insurance? Let us fight for you. The TicketSurgeon.com at 855-WIN-4199.
Looking for a delicious, fresh family meal that's ready when you are and easy on your budget? Welcome to Piara Pizza. We make our pizzas with handmade dough, 100% real cheese, and tomato sauce blended with our own spices. Nothing is ever frozen. We always have large pepperoni and cheese pizzas fresh and waiting for you for only $5. Or choose one of our specialty pizzas. We have veggie, meat lovers, supreme, and Hawaiian. Add an order of our amazing hot wings, cheesy bread, or breadsticks. Our locations are ultra-modern, ultra-clean, and open 7 days a week. Visit any one of our locations today, or check us out on the web at www.piarapizza.com. Piara Pizza, fresh, hot, and ready for you when you come in. Stop in for your Piara Pizza today.
The Share Foundation is the health division of the Koi Chiropractic Institute, a 501c3 509a2 public nonprofit organization dedicated to the growth and development of the natural health care services, in particular through the chiropractic profession offering health services at the Share clinics in the greater Los Angeles area. Your donations can help in expanding these facilities across the nation, research programs, and public education, thus offering a solution to the many of the health challenges we face. Your donations are tax deductible and can be sent through our website at www.sharefoundation.com. That's www.cherfoundation.com by clicking on the donation button. Thank you.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all.
All right, we are treating ourselves right now. Matt, you mixed up, because everybody likes to put candy and stuff in their popcorn.
Some people like M&M's.
What'd you put?
Goobers and snow caps.
Nice.
Two of my really favorites good. From old school candy.
I like putting hot tamales.
It's all stuck in the bottom.
I know.
It's too heavy.
No, the popcorn wasn't hot enough to actually melt it a little, just stick it together.
Put it together.
Well,
yeah.
If you have a favorite candy you like to mix on your popcorn, give us a call, 855-693-4897. No one wanted to call in for free
tickets.
You
know, I want to say, when you posted on the wow, I've been drinking too much.
It's the butter beer, ladies and gentlemen. The
Culinary Trend Show.
Stupefy!
When you posted on the Culinary Trend Show Facebook page,
right.
Someone, you know, you asked what people like to sneak into movie
right.
theaters, and someone said he hasn't been brave enough to do alcohol. You can do it. That's what I want. I believe in you.
Dude,
there
I've snuck
a way.
I've snuck worse things in than
I know.
Alcohol
there is
the
a way
theater.
To do it.
Well, tell us, Gloria. How shall one sneak
I can't
in alcohol at a movie theater?
People are going to know me, and they're going to go, look, there's the drunk
they
girl.
They have your photo.
They have my photo everywhere.
They're like, 12 o'clock, 12 o'clock. There
Search
she
her
is.
Search her purse.
Get her.
Banned.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, we
but
did
there
have,
are ways.
Well, everybody, I asked, like, what do they like? What were their favorite snacks in the movies? We had, like, your typical, like, Twizzlers. Manny had said he likes to bring in carne asada burritos and beer.
That's, yeah. He did
but that's,
say that.
That's Manny Pantalones. What else do we get? A lot of the old school candies that...
What I used to do when I was little was stop at the friendly neighborhood 7-Eleven store, stock up with a big purse, and then go into the movie theater.
Well, I still do that. That's what I want to know. Who
but for your
in?
Kids, you know?
It's expensive. It's
expensive. I would sneak a big bowl of wheat. Oh, wait.
Wheat thins. He would sneak in a big bowl of Wheat Thins. All right, if you don't know the contest, we're going to go ahead and give you the answer because it's one of my favorite movies
now
at all
I
time.
I get to go to the movies.
You win. Do you know the answer?
Pulp Fiction.
Pulp Fiction was the answer. If you don't know what our contest was, you were going to win a pair of tickets to see one of your new favorite movies that are coming out. So let's show that scene because it's one of the...
What do you think?
I think it's like a wax museum with a pulse.
Hi, I'm Buddy. What can I get you?
Let's see, steak. Oh, yeah, the Douglas Sirk steak. Now that.
How do you want that cooked? Run to a crisp or bloody as hell?
Bloody as hell, and oh, yeah, look at this. Vanilla Coke.
What about you, Peggy Sue?
I'll have the Durward Kirby burger, bloody, and a $5 shake.
How do you want that shake? Martin and Lewis or Amos and Andy?
Martin and Lewis.
Did you just order a $5 shake?
Mm-hmm.
That's a shake. That's milk and ice cream.
Last I heard.
That's $5. You don't put bourbon in or nothing?
No.
Just check.
I'll be right back with your drinks.
Answer to this movie, you would have won tickets. So congratulations,
you,
Gloria.
Thank you. Now I can one of these cowboys to go with me.
Yes. Would it be
Juan? This one, cowgirl.
Juan from New Mexico. Juan, if you're listening, call us. We miss you.
They only miss you because they keep making fun of me.
She's taking her butter root beer drink, whatever, with her. Right?
Yeah, she is. And her pajamas.
And my pajamas.
Her eggplant pajamas.
You're only joking because he voted for my PJs.
Whatever,
and not for
whatever. Oh, man. It's hot in here because of that butter beer. It's that butter beer's fault, and that's really delicious. So if you want that recipe, Gloria, tell them what's in there again.
Wow. Butterscotch. Okay, now I can't say it. I'm sorry. I'll post it on my Twitter.
Butter
and what's your Twitter handle?
Zoe02. Zoe02.
How about like people who annoy you at the movie theater? Besides that lady who...
Tall people.
Or that 13-year-old. Tall people.
I always get tall people right in front of me, and I have
me
to
too.
Move.
Me too.
You know what gets me is that... That's kind of part of it. When you sit there and the theater's completely empty and that person has to sit
right in front of you.
Yeah, it's like...
It happens every time to me.
Or behind you and put their feet up. That's... I'm going to knock your feet down and knock you down too because that's nasty to put your feet right behind me and think you're lounging, you know.
I've got to
especially
the point.
When I'm eating.
Yeah.
You know? I'm trying to enjoy myself, my popcorn.
Your booze that you
snuck
in.
Booze that I snuck in.
Well, I mean, those new theaters, those fancy schmancy ones that we were talking about, I've seen those chairs. I mean, it's just like they have lounge chairs.
You know, and a person pays so much to have the whole food experience, the food, you know, the drink experience. And for someone to ruin it for you, you know, I think you deserve to say something.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
no.
I think that's we become a society where we just don't think about other people's feelings. No,
I'm always quick to come.
The person texting behind you, it may be...
Yeah, well,
I'm muted or whatever, but I still see the light is bugging the crap out of me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm so quick to like leave the theater, go to management, go look, I'm not having a good time here. I just need to get my money back or something.
I need my money back, and I need some free passes.
Yeah.
Free.
You guys
free
need to have
food.
Snack bar passes. Yeah.
Well, how about those people that just like they're so loud and obnoxious behind you, like mocking or you know laughing so loud.
That's me. I have to say. I am a loud
person. Oh, I thought we were about
to
get
laugh.
Racial for a second.
No.
All right, let's do it. When we're done with him, he'll be more of an outcast than a seagull at an Adam Sandler movie.
This is my old bicycle that I had from when I was 10. Sometimes the banana seat hurts my hiney.
Will you shut up?
You shut up, man. It's a comedy.
When I ring the bell, it makes my pants feel funny. Ring, ring, ring.
Like a hyena. I have to say.
Do people turn around and say,
No, because...
Will you stop laughing like a hyena? Or it's going to be that 13-year-old girl.
It's going to be the 13-year-old girl, yeah. No, I quickly, like... put my hand in my mouth.
I'm trying to text here to find my... Yeah, that sounds familiar.
Is that the are we doing the El Grito contest again? Is that what's going on?
The El Grito.
That was fun.
That was fun. That was Nat won.
Yeah, what Nat did I win? Won.
He won the Chewbacca sound.
He did.
You won popcorn, my friend. Oh, and you had to fill it up yourself and put candy yourself. There you go.
There. That was good. Mine.
That was you.
That's me recorded on there. Yeah.
Oh, you should have seen her body.
You came back in after the show to like do it professionally.
I did, and that's my gallo that I came with.
Oh, nice,
yeah.
Nice.
She brought her gallo. A.K.A. Anyway, so we are mixing up candy. If you have a favorite candy you want to mix up, 855-693-4897. That's what you like in yours. What did you have in there? Goobers and what else?
Goobers and snow caps. Uh-huh. I like the dark chocolate raisinets, too. I'm a big, like, bittersweet, dark chocolate kind of
person.
Did you
eat my popcorn?
No, some people like M&M.
I was trying to get to the ones in the bottom. So
trail mix is really good. I've had it with trail mix. Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, you know they're making those M&Ms now with the pretzels in them and the trail mix and everything. All.
Ew. Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I like peanut M&Ms in my popcorn.
But I do love it when it all melts together and it makes like a popcorn ball. That is so good.
I think we should have fun. I think a lot of new things are happening, like the Rocky Horror Show. Everybody sings along. I think we need to do a sing-along.
Oh, yes.
So everybody, if you know this one, Lawrence has to sing. Chef
Lawrence
Nan
and I, we were
sing.
Doing a sing-along earlier.
Were you?
Yeah. Sing.
So we were warming up earlier.
What
we were
warming up. Here.
So if you're watching, we want you all to sing along with us.
Thank you for listening.
Thank you for listening.
Sing-along not playing in your town
by the hundred.
We should have done the other one. We go together like
thank you. Thank you. Are we American Idol?
I think the grease thing is more of a female thing, though.
You think so?
I did. See, we warmed up to Summer Lovin'. You should have been.
I never watched that.
Summer Lovin'?
Never watched that movie.
Alan
and
was
said
listening,
it was
so he
fun.
Knows.
Did you enjoy it as a guy?
With
Grease?
Wait a minute. You have no choice. When you take us to a movie, you have no choice but to enjoy it also.
You know, I'm sorry. I'm the type of girl where I'm not going to drag the guy I'm seeing to a chick flick if he doesn't enjoy it.
Exactly. Well, that's boo. All I'm saying. Boo. How would you know? Are you going to ask him first?
No.
Do you
take
chick
my
flicks?
Friends. Yeah.
Would you do the sing-along with your friends?
I would.
See? But if you had your honey and, you know,
what?
Would you do the sing-along next to your honey?
I would.
Well, you used to do the Rocky Horror Picture Show back in the day.
Yeah, that's bad. Do they still have it?
They
have
still
it
do over at the
in
New
Long
Art.
They do.
The New Art, I think, still does it over on the west side.
We used to do it at Balboa.
The Balboa Theater?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They still do it in Long Beach.
But you have to be ham-boned. You know, no one in there's
I
want to
be magenta.
Right,
I want to go.
I love that
dress
movie.
Up like magenta. I love her.
Well, we want to thank everybody from.
Let's do the time warp again.
Everyone, we're going to do that next week. We're not here next week.
Oh, is that?
Just to let you know, we're not here. We're going to be
so
off for a
week.
We're taking a break, but we will be back in a week.
We have to go to an intervention.
Yes, we'll have an intervention for you. We're going to give you 1 week to clean up, young lady. So we will return in. I'm going to have the rest.
2 weeks.
In 2 weeks from now. So everybody have a safe and happy holiday weekend. Thank you to all the listeners and viewers here at rantradionetwork.com and
our new listeners.
And new listeners.
Indie 104.
We love you guys. Thank you so much. Have a great weekend. Be safe and eat lots of good food.
6 minutes.
As everyone knows, rainbows usually have a treasure at the end. Let's follow this one and see if we can find the pot of gold.
Mother, and I suppose you've come to claim me treasure.
Well, we'd like to see the gold first.
Ethan, there's better than gold in here, me lad. No, just look here, no.
Candy, refreshing soft drinks, popcorn, Ice cream? Well, that's some treasure, but anyone can buy luscious treats like these at the snack bar.
You don't tell me! Do you suppose you could get me a job as a snack bar attendant?
Show starts in 5.
Did you ever want to have your own radio show?
No.